ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் நிறைய பேர் இருக்காங்க.
நீ நானும் ஒப்புனா
ஆரம்பிச்சுவாங்க. Let us discuss about quantum mechanics today. Please take notes. Already I have taken two classes regarding kinematics. Do you remember or not? Okay. See, what we have discussed so far was classical mechanics. Now we are entering into quantum mechanics. Right? What do you say about your classical mechanics? We have discussed the dynamics, that is kinetics and the kinematics of the body. There we have discussed some equations of motion, Newton's first law, second law, third law, something like that we have discussed. Is it not? What do you say? Now, we are going to apply similar to this in the quantum mechanics also. First, let us see, there are two worlds here. One is classical world, another is quantum world. In the classical world, we are dealing with all these things here, which are macroscopic in nature. We are discussing with the macroscopic particles. Whereas here, we are going to discuss about a microscopic in nature. Here we are going to say, if you take any particle, that particle is localized. Here it is not so, it is not localized. Here we are going to apply the concept of probability technique. Whether the particle is available or not can be determined by finding the probability technique. Here we have used V equal to U plus AT, something like that. Something like this. Here we are going to use Schrodinger's equation. Here we have used S equal to U T plus R T square, like that we have discussed S V square equal to U square plus 2AS, like that. Here we have Schrodinger's time independent equation, Schrodinger's time dependent equation. Then we have here solved a few problems. I think one problem on the day I have given as a homework. Is it overspeed or not? Likewise, here we have a technique here called particle in a box. We are going to discuss a concept called particle in a box. Then quantum harmonic oscillator, that problem we are going to discuss. Still few things are there, let me explain one by one. Before going into the quantum mechanics topic, let us discuss few things here, so that you can be motivated. See, you are joined here to get a B degree. Of course, we are all teaching quantum mechanics and all. The necessity of teaching this quantum mechanics to you is to impart certain concepts in the quantum world. Especially, nowadays you are having a technology called quantum computing. Quantum computation, we used to say. Then, in the space, we are having a lot of informations. They are all in the form of very small, in the form of fields. We call it as quantum informations. Once if you can able to achieve a little bit in this quantum aspect, definitely you can go as a very good inventing engineer. After all, what we are doing now, we are all skilled engineers. And we are, our job is to do like this. I think you can easily understand this diagram. If there is any company like this, this is the roadmap of the company. This roadmap is, say, try to understand it. the skilled engineer, professional engineer, what we are talking around, making this company to move from $1 million company into $1 billion company, $1 billion into $1 trillion, double trillion, like that we are going on making the company to improve and improve. That is our task in our life, because we are capable of working, understanding certain things, you can able to do the job allotted to you while you are working in any company. But once if you think about the person who are here, he is going on becoming a millionaire, billionaire, trillionaire, like that. Why don't you make yourself to be in this way? Think about it. Once if you are thinking about this type of concepts in your mind, definitely you can study well and you can excel in your engineering course. Of course, this quantum concept may be a tool for you. இந்த குவாண்டத்தை கொஞ்சம் அப்படியே படித்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா அது நிறைய விஷயம் இருக்குது, ஏகப்பட்ட விஷயம் இருக்குது. யூ கேன் அப்ளை அண்ட் யூ கேன் ஸ்டார்ட் யுவர் ஓன் கம்பெனி. ஐ திங்க் ஐ கேன் சே ஒன் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட், யூ கேன் ஈஸிலி ஃபில் இட் ஒன் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட். ஒன் பர்சன் இஸ் டெல்லிங், ஐ திங்க் யூ கேன் ஈஸிலி அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் இட், டெல்லிங் லைக் திஸ், ஐ ஃபெயில்டு இன் மெனி சப்ஜெக்ட்ஸ் டியூரிங் மை டிகிரி கோர்ஸ். மை ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் பாஸ்ட் இன் ஆல் சப்ஜெக்ட்ஸ், காட் place in very good company, but I am the owner of the company. Who is he? Who is he? Bill Gates. So likewise, we are having number of persons are there. Steve Jobs, Ford, Honda, like that, many people are there. So they are thinking themselves differently. So they are using their brain for themselves. So of course they are giving job to all. So in this way, you just be motivated to do the work in different way, so that in this class the quantum concept may be very much useful to you. Is it clear? Right. Now, let us discuss about one small concept here, we can call it as, see, do you know what is one bit? What is bit stands for? Binary digit. See, now, you are having 0 or 1, is it done? What do you say? So, we are storing this data by using something called electronics, is it done? In electronic devices, we are storing it. Nowadays, we are having a technology called spintronics. What they are doing now, they are taking atom and electron in it and they are switching over the spinning of the electron. By switching the spinning of the electron, they are capable of storing ones and zeros. That is one direction with which our engineering is progressing. That topic we call it as spintronics. Are you clear? Likewise, in quantum, we are having the same concept I will explain afterwards. That is what we call as qubit, what is called as quantum bits. Once if you say in binary 0 and 1, in the case of quantum bit, you are having all number of datas in between 0 and 1. So sometime I will explain this quantum bit, okay, very clearly. Now, let us start with our so-called experiment, that is Young's double slit experiment. Do you know? I think you must have studied, is it not? See, when you take a double slit like this, and if you are trying to pass electromagnetic waves, or even electrons to pass through, you can find on the other side of the slit, we have a screen. In the screen, we can able to see the, what's that? Interference pattern. bright and dark. Karuppu vella patta varum illaya padrigila Tamil medium. So we are having an interference pattern here. So here we are having waves coming like this, coming like this. So you may say that there is diffraction here, believe me, believe. Likewise you may say here, no. See, there is superimpose of two waves coming from the two slits, having same amplitude, same frequency or wavelength, traveling in the same direction. They superimpose each other and they produce interference pattern on the screen. Okay, this is what happened. Here we have a concept that this is the turning point of our quantum mechanics. We have here called a dual nature. You can find one aspect here. Once if you are observing the process happening here with the help of some detector, using some detector, for example, you are observing it. You are observing what is happening in between, whether it is behaving like a wave, as we have seen wave itself, or particle, as we have seen particle like electrons. Once we are going on thinking about what is the mechanism taking place here with the help of a device, some detector, definitely you can find that this interference pattern disappear. That's what they have observed. So the quantum concept is probability, that is all the events taking place are all in the form of possibilities only, possibilities. Once if you are interrupt in the during this possibility events, definitely you can find this process is disturbed. In the process enada disturb aagudhu kandupidichirukanga. Are clear not? So once if you are touching that aspect, what it is happening here during the, so it is very important aspect, we have to think about it. So the process taking place here is in the form of quantum mechanical point of view only. It is based on what is called as possibilities. Got it? Likewise in your life also you can take it like this. Whenever you want to achieve any task, for that you are planning and you are trying to implement the task. Once if you are opening that secret to your enemies, definitely the task will not be succeeded. Of course your well-wisher parents may energize this wave which you are expecting to take place. எந்த அளவுக்கு எடு நடக்குங்கிறது நீங்கள் நினைச்சாலும் உங்கள் பேரண்ட்ஸ் வெல்விஷன் நினைச்சா நடக்கும். ஒன்ஸ் இஃப் யூ ஃபைண்ட் தட் எனி சச் எ பர்சன் லைக் திஸ் டிடெக்டிங் திஸ் டெஃபினெட்லி இட் வில் பி இன்டரப்டட். யூ கேன் ஈஸிலி அப்ளை இட் இன் யுவர் லைஃப் அண்ட் யூ கேன் ஈஸிலி ஐடென்டிஃபைட் வேர் எனிமி ஆர் ஃப்ரெண்ட் லைக் தட் யூ கேன் ஈஸிலி அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் இட். அது கிளியர் தட்ஸ் வாட் யூ சே. நிறைவாகும் வரை மறைவாக இரு. ஒரு கான்செப்ட் முடிகிற வரைக்கும் அதை மறைச்சி வச்சுருக்கோங்க. இட்ஸ் நாட் ஏ ஓப்பன் சீக்ரெட் டு ஆல். ஓகே ரைட். நவ் வி பாஸ் ஆன் டு த அதர் ஒன். குவாண்டம் என்டாங்கிள்மெண்ட், இதெல்லாம் இன்ட்ரடக்ஷன் மாதிரி தான் உங்களுக்கு. Entanglement. Very simple concept only, but you may wonder what is happening here, how it is happening here like this. Of course, these are the cause for the quantum computation. Quantum communication also, even without wire, even you can transfer the data. All these things can happen by this technique, what is called as quantum entanglement. Of course, see, try to understand it. You consider there is an atom. There are two electrons in this atom. If you are taking one electron of this atom to this position, say infinite distance, a 5 kilometer or 10 kilometer like that, you take the other electron to the other side, say another 10 kilometers or infinite distance. If you find this is like this, having a spin like this, this is having a spin like this, you can find that they maintain their spin as long as it is not disturbed. Once if you are disturbing it, if you are disturbing this one, automatically in no time it will be disturbed. No time it is disturbed. உடனே மாறிடும். இது நீ என்ன டிஸ்டர்ப் பண்ணுறியோ அது நடக்கும். ஸோ டு யூ ஹாவ் எனி சச் எ ரிசீவர் ட்ரான்ஸ்மிட்டர் எனி திங் லைக் தட்? நோ. ஸோ யூ ஆர் டிஸ்டர்பிங் த ப்ராபபிலிட்டி சுச்சுவேஷன் அவைலபிள் ஹியர். டெஃபினெட்லி யூ கேன் ஃபைண்ட் ஒன்ஸ் திஸ் இஸ் டிஸ்டர்ப்ட் ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்கலி திஸ் இஸ் ஆல்சோ டிஸ்டர்ப்ட். ஸோ தீஸ் ஆர் ஆல் என்டாங்கிள்ட் கனெக்டட் டு திஸ் ஆட்டம். Likewise, you might have experienced if there are two persons, say twins, once a particular person got fever, definitely the other person will also, I think, might have experienced, because the time taken and period and the energy absorbed from the mother are all same for both of them. They are entangled. So likewise, we are having many concepts here. So if you apply these type of concepts while you are studying in the higher semesters with a concept called quantum concept, definitely you can come up. There will be a lot of opening to you. Are you clear? For that purpose only, we have started our bridge course. This little bit introduction about our quantum mechanics topic. Are you clear? Okay, right. The starting point, I think you can easily say 1900. Before that, classical mechanics. Afterwards, we have quantum mechanics. Okay, this time I think X-ray was designed. X-ray invented. So it may be a tool for us to identify what is happening in the atomic level. So that may be the cause for the development of studying the microscopic particles, and hence we are entering into a new field called a quantum field. Are you clear? So it may be a tool for it. Of course, while you are going on studying about the nature, especially nature of light, all this in here, you are having a difficulty of explaining photoelectric effect, is it not? That's why we are entering into a quantum theory. Quantum theory, do you know quantum theory or not? Do you know quantum theory? Let me explain about the quantum theory first, then we'll pass on to this one. If you take any source and if you are passing current through this, you can find that it is coming like this, they are telling. Is it that? Small packets of energy called a quantas. Is it that? Actually, before this type of hypothesis, there was a topic called black body radiation. Black body radiation. While they are explaining about the way in which the black body radiation is taking place, especially the name of the scientist, Max Planck, gave this theory in the beginning, that is called quantum theory. He only introduced the word quanta. It means a packet of energy, like I introduced, in order to explain the black body radiation. Let us discuss about this black body radiation for a while, then we'll pass on to the other concepts. Okay? Right. Once if you say it is a black body, it is capable of absorbing all sort of radiations, is it not? Irrespective of the wavelength and irrespective of the angle of incidence, it is capable of absorbing it. So that is the main point about the black body. At the same time, I think you know, one person called Ferri designed a black body. The name of the black body is like this, made up of nickel, two walled material, not isolate the heat radiation, all these things here. Lamp plugged means black and கருப்பு கலர்ல கோட் பண்ணிருப்பாங்க. There is a small projection here. So once if you find any radiation is entering into it, it is completely observed. Such a type of objects or body are called black bodies. Okay, right. If you take the same black body and if you keep it in a sand bath, what do you mean by sand bath? Made up of sand. Here you are keeping that, and if you are heating, definitely it is capable of emitting radiations, all sort of radiation depending upon the temperature that we have applied to the sand. Likewise, we are having such an arrangement, we call this black body. While there are identifying the amount of energy produced by the black body, they have drawn a graph between frequency versus intensity of the radiation coming out from the black body is like this. This is what we call as about 300 K, and this is about 4500 K. This is about 6000 K, stands for Kelvin. So these temperatures, you can find there is an increase in intensity of radiation is coming out like this. And they have given a statement like this: the amount of radiation emitted by the body, I don't know, the amount of radiation emitted by the body is the area enclosed by the curve. For example, if this temperature is 3000 K, and when I am drawing a graph like this, if I find this area, it is like this. The frequency may be like this, 2, 4, 8, in 10 power 14 hertz. Likewise. So here you are having high frequency region, say in the order of ultraviolet. Here we have low frequency region, say in the order of infrared region, like that. So you are having such a radius like this. And during the time, I think you have studied Stefan, gave a law, Stefan's law states that the amount of energy radiated per second is directly proportional to the fourth power of its absolute temperature. Of course, we may be saying in this way, Stefan's constant, 5.67 in 10 power minus 8 watt meter power minus 2 Kelvin power minus 4. Likewise, you might have studied Stefan's law to explain all these things here. And during the time, another scientist named Wien gave Wien's displacement law. If you say frequency is more here, wavelength is less. Here wavelength is large. Wavelength is large in this direction. Here wavelength is less. So you see here, this is the what is called as lambda m. Lambda m means wavelength corresponds to maximum intensity irukkuriya wavelength ku peru lambda m nu peru. You see here, as temperature increases, the lambda m is shifted towards the lower wavelength side. And he told lambda m or lambda max is proportional to 1 by t. So as temperature increases, the lambda m is going towards the lower wavelength side. Likewise, we explain all these concepts here. They are all applicable only for this type of regions only. These regions only it was applicable. Then I think it is all available in your 11th standard book. Can I pass on to the next one? Now, Rayleigh's Jean's law. Rayleigh's Jean law. Rayleigh's Jean law. Okay? See, he told that if you are having a black body, that black body is of course having atoms. These atoms are under simple harmonic oscillations. Are under simple harmonic oscillation. It means that if there is any atom in the position here, it vibrates in its own position simple harmonically. Simple harmonically means the vibration is or oscillation is taking place with respect to the mean position. That is what we call as simple harmonic oscillation. And due to the simple harmonic oscillation, you can find there is thermal motion of atoms, or atoms are under thermal motion in this black body, and they try to generate electromagnetic waves. You can find that the vibrations are in different modes with the less amplitude and going very fast, large amplitude going very slow, like that it is taking place. So you can find that there are number of modes of vibrations. Many modes of vibrations are taking place. Many modes of vibrations are taking place in the system. That's why you are having all these things are happening here from the system. Now, at one particular stage, we call it as thermal equilibrium stage. It means the rate of emission of radiation. The rate of emission of radiation is equal to the rate of absorption of radiation is taking place. At that time, you can refer to the statement given by Boltzmann. That is Boltzmann's principle of equipartition of energy. The average energy of average thermal energy is directly proportional to kT. And again, he told or gave the energy equation as a function of frequency nu, E is equal to 8 pi nu square kT divided by C cube. Likewise, scientists are trying to explain the cause for the black body radiation. Of course, these are all not yet completed. They are all applicable only to the region like this. Of course, to this region only, not to the entire region. During the time only, our scientist Max Planck gave a postulate without proof. That is what we call as postulate. Here a statement that the black body which is absorbing the radiation and emitting the radiations are all in the form of discrete in nature. Likewise he told. And he told that the amount of radiation, small quantity of radiation coming out from the black body is about h nu. And this small discrete particle which is coming out from the black body, we call it as quanta. அதுக்கு பேர் குவாண்டம் பேரு. தட் இஸ் இன்டிவிசிபிள் டிஸ்கிரீட் யூனிட் ஆஃப் எனர்ஜி கால்டு ஹெச் நியூ. தட் இஸ் கால்டு குவாண்டா. இட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் எனர்ஜி குவாண்டம். லைக் கைஸ் யூ ஹவ் அஃப்கோர்ஸ் ஹி கேவ் அ ஃபார்முலா. தட் ஃபார்முலா இஸ் 8π the extension of Rayleigh Jeans law, h nu cube divided by c cube into 1 by e power h nu by kt minus 1. Of course with this full formula we can able to explain the entire radiation. Without this, what is called as Planck's concept of introducing all these things here, once if you are applying our Rayleigh Jeans concept, we have a thing called ultraviolet catastrophe. It means that it is applicable only to this region, not to the UV region. It was very tough task for us. That's why our Planck formulated this type of radiation, and the formula derived by him is this one. When you are having a difference of energy nu, that is equal to into nu. For small energy distribution, if you have a small energy distribution like this, you can find it. The small energy distribution in this can be represented by using this formula. Are you clear? So this is the turning point in our quantum mechanics. I think of course this is a starting point for us to look into this. Of course you might have studied in your 12th standard that while you are explaining about the nature of light, quantum theory given by Einstein. He took the Max Planck's quantum theory only and he extended it. Of course, the starting point is Max Planck's quantum theory only. Of course, during this quantum nature of light, dual nature of light, all these things here, given by Einstein. Of course, the base is this one only. This is the base. Any doubt in this? And he only formulated a thing called a photon. During the time there were another experiments. They are photoelectric effects. Compton effect. So this photoelectric effect and Compton effect could not be explained by using our classical theory such as Newton's corpuscular theory, Huygens wave theory, Maxwell's electromagnetic theory. So we need another theory to be used to explain this type of photoelectric effect. Of course, Einstein succeeded in explaining the photoelectric effect by using that quantum theory. I think you know very well, I can easily explain it. See, if you have a photosensitive material like this, and if you find certain photons are trying to fall on this material in the form of an electromagnetic waves, if you take a UV ray to fall on a photosensitive material, say ZNO, something like that, materials, you can find that electrons are emitted from it. Electrons are emitted from it. If you think that it is in the form of a wave, how can you find electrons are coming out from it? So it is in the form of a dual character, that's why it is happening like that. And you can find the photon which is coming from the source may have an energy h nu, is trying to fall on the target, and the two it is falling on the atom, the two it is falling on the electron inside the atom and imparts this energy to the electron, and hence this energy is used to remove the electron, is used to remove the electron. For example, 5 electron volt of energy is available here. Once if you want to remove an electron from this orbit, say 3 electron volt energy is needed. So among 5 electron volt of energy, 3 electron volt of energy is used to remove the electron from that atom, from that orbit, and the remaining 2 electron volt is available in the electron in the form of kinetic energy. He wrote an equation like this. Of course, we can able to understand it. That too, the kinetic energy is maximum because it is an elastic collision. The energy is conserved, kinetic energy is conserved, and hence you are getting maximum kinetic energy is available here. This we may be calling it as work function, and this frequency we may call it as threshold frequency. For example, if you are sending a photon of energy 7 electron volt, this photon will not remove 2 electrons, though it is capable of having 7 electron volt, it is trying to remove only 1 electron. Of course, the energy needed for that removal of that electron is 3 electron volt. The remaining 4 electron volt is available in the form of kinetic energy. Are you clear? Once if the photon is having energy less than this 3 electron volt of energy, say 2 electron volt, and if the intensity is very high, definitely this electron volt, that is 2 electron volt photon, cannot remove this. So these type of explanations were given by Einstein. Of course, for that he got a Nobel Prize. Then we have another thing called Compton effect. Are you all following it or not? For example, there is an electromagnetic radiation of wavelength lambda is falling on an electron. Of course, we may call it as target electron. And the energy possessed by it is given to this, and it is going like this. This may be called as scattered photon. This photon may have a wavelength lambda dash. Then, of course, this electron is not at free space or isolated space. It is bounded with an atom only. Like this only, we are bounded. This electron now knocked out. Now this electron is recoiling, going out, and this we call it as recoil electron. If this angle is phi, that is the name of the scientist, Compton, and this one we call it as Compton effect. He derived lambda dash is equal to lambda plus h by m naught c into 1 minus cos phi. Angle of scattering. Rest mass of the electron, Planck's constant, velocity of light. So the wavelength of the scattered photon is more than the incident photon. Wavelength increased means energy decreased, because E is equal to h nu or h c by lambda. As long as wavelength is less, energy is more. Once we say wavelength is increased, energy is decreased. So try to understand it. Now we pass on to the different aspects. They are particle property of wave and wave property of particle. For example, if you are having a vessel having water, and of course if you are putting a stone on this still water, you can find that there are ripples. The ripples are nothing but carrier of momentum and energy and momentum. How can you take this energy from one place to another place? There must be a carrier. Of course, we may say that it is traveling in the form of wave. You can find that there must be a particle associated with that. Please try to write. There must be a particle associated with that. And because of this only, the particle available in the water, of course the water is having the two properties, very important properties. What are they? Velocity, and the particle is having a property called inertia. Inertia irukkanaalayum, mass irukkanaalayum, mil thanmai, elasticity irukkanaalayum, inge irukkuri energy, the energy available at the place of the stone falling on the water is carried outward, is going outward like this. Are you clear now? So there is a particle associated with the wave here. Likewise, do you know what is called as pitcher tube? In front of you are having a monitor. They are all made up of TFT, thin film technology monitors. Before this, we had a monitor called a VDU, visual display unit, like this, the olden one. So we call this CRT, cathode ray tube. Here we have a thing called a electron gun. These electrons are trying to fall on the screen, and hence you can find there is a process called scintillation is taking place. Scintillation is taking place, and hence the energy carried by the electron from the electron gun while falling on the photosensitive material, it is converted into light, photons. Likewise, many things are there, and of course all these processes, if you take our water wave, it is going like this. It is characterized by using its amplitude. Likewise, if you take a sound wave, the sound wave is due to compression, rarefaction. Compression, rarefaction, compression rarefaction. Likewise, we are having. So here we have a concept of difference in pressure. So these are the cause for here. Here the cause is charge and a mass. Likewise, we are having a criteria. So with that, we are having wave property in particle, particle property in wave are all taking place in the system. Number of things are there. Of course, you can easily understand this concept. And as long as when you are saying that it is in the form of a wave, I think you know rectilinear propagation, refraction, reflection, interference, diffraction, is it a polarization, all these things are happening. Once if you say photoelectric effect is satisfied by the theory, you must say a particle also. Likewise, Compton effect, interaction of light and matter. You should say interaction of light and matter. So that is a basic concept with which we are producing X-rays. Fast moving electrons are falling on a target, that too on an electron. The electrons are taken to a higher orbit. While they are jumping to the original position or higher orbit, they are giving photon. That photon, we call it as X-ray. So there is interaction of particle and matter, likewise wave and matter is taking place here. So wave is associated with that particle, and particle is manifested in the form of a wave. So likewise, we are having situation available in action. Now one person called De Broglie, a turning point in physics, introduced a concept called, what's that? Matter wave. A wave is associated with a particle. If this is a particle, automatically there is some wave associated with that. Over particle, wave on the associated argument, so that we call it as matter wave. I think you might have used the same concept without knowing all these things here. In the case of your electron microscope, there you might have used like this. You are sending what's called as electrons to pass through the specimen, and you are analyzing the nature of the specimen with the help of a CRT or something else. At that time, you are sending electrons, but you may say the wavelength is in the order of 10 power minus 12 meter or 0.01 angstrom. So you are having electron, but you are representing in this. So what you say here? Wavelength is associated with that electron. Wavelength is associated with electron. Likewise, you might have studied. Now I will calculate how much amount of wavelength. I think 12,400 divided by root of V, something like that, you might have studied. Is it that? Participating about maximum wavelength. So likewise, we are having a concept. And this De Broglie wavelength, lambda, I think you might have studied and derived, is it that? What is that? H by P or MV. H by MV or P. What is that? P here? Momentum. So this particle is having mass as long as a particle in nature. Once if you say it is in wave nature, you may say wavelength lambda is associated with that. Appa or wave irundhuchuna adha particle irukum. Adhe maari ஒரு பார்ட்டிகிள் இருந்தால் அதில் வேல் இருக்கும் அப்படிங்கிறத De Broglie வந்து தெளிவாக சொல்லிட்டார், கால்குலேட் பண்ணி கொடுத்தாரு. எனி டவுட் இன் திஸ்? எனி டவுட் இன் திஸ்? இஃப் யூ ஆர் ஆக்சலரேட்டிங் எலக்ட்ரான் வித் த பொட்டன்ஷியல் வி, த அமௌண்ட் ஆஃப் எனர்ஜி இஸ் ஹாஃப் எம் வி ஸ்கொயர் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு இவி. ஸோ மல்டிப்ளை எம் ஆன் நியூமரேட்டர்
என்ன பண்ணுறாங்களோ வேண்டியது.
So the momentum P is root of 2m EV, and hence your lambda is h by root of 2m EV. You might have studied these things. So these are all called deep learning concepts. Right. Right. See, if you take a wave in a string, you may say this amplitude or some displacement, something like that. If you take a sound wave, you may have compression, rarefaction, like that. So there we are representing pressure. Likewise, we are having a matter wave associated with that. We are going to represent with the help of a quantity called a wave function. Please write it. That wave function, we call it as psi. Be silent. Psi. So here afterwards we are going to write psi. Before that we might have used it, a, y is equal to some a cos omega t, something like that, sin omega t, we might have used it, displacement for this. Whereas here we are going to introduce the quantity called, physical quantity called wave function for this. Of course, when you take this psi, it is simply related to the matter wave. It doesn't have any physical significance. Amplitude mari solam diyade, pressure mari solam diyade. You could not able to express like amplitude or displacement or pressure like that. Of course, this may be useful for finding the particle available at that place or not. அந்த இடத்துல அந்த பார்ட்டிகல் இருக்காங்கிறத கண்டுபிடிக்கிறதுக்கு பயன்படும். ஒரு இடத்துல வேவ் ஃபங்க்ஷன் இவ்வளோன்னு சொன்னபோது இவ்வளோ வேவ் ஃபங்க்ஷன் இருந்துச்சுன்னா அங்கே பார்ட்டிகல் இருக்குன்னு அர்த்தம். லைக் வைஸ் இட் இஸ் யூஸ் டு ரெப்ரசன்ட் த ஆர் ஃபைண்டிங் த பார்ட்டிகல் அட் தட் பிளேஸ். சே இஃப் யூ டேக் அ ஸ்பேஸ் எக்ஸ் ஒய் இசட் ஸ்பேஸ் அட் எனி டைம் டி, வென் யூ வாண்ட் டு ஃபைண்ட் வெதர் த பார்ட்டிகல் இஸ் அவைலபிள் ஹியர் ஆர் நாட், ஃபார் தட் we are having a quantity called a psi for that one. Are you clear? There is no significance for this. If you take the quantity psi square, this may be useful. This may be always a positive quantity. We call it as absolute quantity. Always positive value because we are taking a modulus of this one, and of course we are getting this is what we call as probability density. It may be called as probability density to find the particle at that place. Of course it may be represented as psi into psi star, something like that. We may be using it in course of time. We will use it. Right. So if there is any particle, if there is a wave like that, we are representing with the help of a wave function psi. It means that it is psi is used to describe the particle being spread out in that space. And the space where the particle spread out or capturing. Suppose, for instance, the whole atom may be either present or may not present. Suppose we may say 20%, it means that 20% of electron is present in the place. No, it is not meaning to say 20% of the electron is present there. The probability of finding the electron in that space may be 20%. Maybe 20%. This is the probability of finding the electron in that particular place. If you say this many wave functions associated with the particles available in that place per unit time, when you say that is called as actual density. We have studied probability density. It is called actual density. If you are having certain particles having wave function psi at any time t, if you find these particles are having psi, and when you find the value psi modulus square, that may be called as actual density, because all these particles are having same psi. Ellathukum ore psi irukana appo solla. So probability may be more or less. So depending upon that, we are having it. Right. Now we pass on to wave velocity. Wave velocity. This is a particle. Here we have a wave. I am going to find the velocity of this wave. In the wave node, velocity of one. This is a particle. In the particle mass m moving with the velocity v, the de Broglie wave velocity, of the wave, de Broglie velocity of the particle w is equal to nu lambda. And you can write from de Broglie concept, lambda is nothing but a h by mv. From Einstein concept, E is equal to mc square. So now the total energy from Max Planck's concept, it is h nu. So now you are going to use these two, and you are going to find the value of nu. Nu is nothing but mc square by h. So take the value of lambda and nu, substitute it in this place. You will get w, that is de Broglie wave velocity, is equal to lambda, sorry, what is that nu? Nu is nothing but m c square by h into h by mv. So cancel these things here. You see here c square by v. So this is the wave velocity with which it is moving, that wave associated with the particle is moving. Of course, you see here that v is always less than c. V when the velocity of light power, the particle in the velocity when the light velocity will be higher. So your w is greater than the velocity of light. So the wave associated with the particle travels faster than speed. So the speed of the velocity of the matter wave associated with the particle travels faster than the speed. That is the conclusion which we are getting here. Now, in order to enter into the topic quantum mechanics, all these things here, you please try to understand the wave equation for a string wave. That is, you are having a string attached to the thing like that. For example, For example, if the wave is traveling like this, it may be represented as y is equal to a sine omega t. If it is starting from here like that, it may be represented as y is equal to a cos omega t. I think you all very well that omega is nothing but angular frequency, that is 2 pi into linear frequency. So you can write your equation a cos 2 pi nu into t. If this way, you just consider this way, you consider this way, okay? If this way started earlier, in that case, what to do? You have to subtract some quantity here. So the wave velocity W is equal to x by t. T is equal to x by W. This much time we have to subtract. So A cos 2 pi nu within bracket t minus x by W you have to subtract. Then now we are just manipulating this equation very simply like that. cos 2 pi into nu t minus nu into x by W. That W may be written as, I think now only we have studied this, W is equal to nu lambda. So cos 2 pi nu t minus nu x by nu into lambda. So you can cancel this nu and this nu. So you are getting the value as y is equal to a cos, even if you can take this 2 pi inside, you will get 2 pi nu t minus 2 pi x by lambda into t, as a by lambda. So you can write this one as a cos, this can be written as omega t minus 2 pi by lambda. I am going to say one new parameter called k, I will tell you afterwards, k into x. What is that k? K is nothing but 2 pi by lambda. This 2 pi by lambda we call it as wave number. Here afterwards we are going to use the formula in this way only. I will use all these things here by this type of string wave equations only. So please have this in your mind. So here afterwards I may subtract minus k into x. That minus k into x might have been here due to the starting point maybe earlier. If it is started here, the epoch may be 0. If it is started here, the epoch may be 90. கொஞ்சம் அதிகமாக இருந்துச்சு, 98 அதிகமாக இருக்கு. இஃப் இட் இஸ் சம் அதர் வேல்யூ யூ ஹவ் டு சே த வேல்யூ ஈக்குவல் டு எக்ஸ் பை டி யூ ஹவ் டு சே. ஸோ ஃபார் தட் யூ ஆர் கெட்டிங் த ஈக்குவேஷன் லைக் திஸ். நவ் லெட் அஸ் டிஸ்கஸ் ஃபேஸ் வெலாசிட்டி அண்ட் குரூப் வெலாசிட்டி. ஃபேஸ் வெலாசிட்டி அண்ட் குரூப் வெலாசிட்டி. Just have an atom, you are having a wave associated with that. The waves associated with this may not have same velocity. So we may say that the waves associated with the particles, okay, may be called as a group of waves. Group of waves are there, and this group of waves need not have same velocity. எல்லாத்துக்கும் ஒரே வெலாசிட்டி இருக்காது. When you find the amplitude of the wave, it may give the probability of finding the particle at that place, at that instant. So, we could not express the wave y is equal to a cos omega t minus ax. We could not express it like this. We ought to express it with this certain wave, because we are having number of waves are associated with that. You could not expect the wave is like this. Of course, the wave may be like this way. Like this. This is the type of wave available for this particle. We are going to discuss this one. Of course, you might have studied a concept called beats. You are having two tuning forks. One is having 450 hertz, another one is having 455 hertz. If they are sounded in a particular place, you can find that they superimpose and produce a new wave. If you look into the pattern with which the superimposition is taking place and the resultant one may be like this. So like this you may be. So what is happening here? You are having waxing and panning. Waxing and panning is taking place. So the wave which we have associated with our matter wave, matter, may be in this form, in the marg. But we are saying like this. Of course, it may be time consuming, leave it. So it is like this way only. So we have to take the value like this. Y equal to y1 equal to something and y2 equal to something. The second wave may have difference in delta D, W we have to put and B, K we have to put. Small difference in wave number to be added, small difference in angular frequency to be added, and hence you are having two waves and the resultant may be in the form of a beats which we have studied in the sound topic. Okay, so the wave is like this. Now let us calculate the group velocity. Before that, let us take the phase velocity. W is equal to omega by k. Omega by k. Of course, this may be derived from the formula nu lambda. For this, you multiply 2 pi in the numerator and denominator. This 2 pi may become a omega, and 2 pi by lambda may become a wave number k. அந்த மாதிரி ஒரு ஈக்குவேஷன் வரும். இதான் வந்து வெலாசிட்டி ஆஃப் த மேட்டர் வேவ், ஃபேஸ் வெலாசிட்டி வி மே சே. நவ் லெட் அஸ் என்டர் இன் டு த கான்செப்ட் கால் குரூப் வெலாசிட்டி. தட் மே பி யூ இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு டிடபிள்யூ பை டிகே. தட் மே பி ரிட்டன் ஆஸ் dw by dv divided by dk by dv. We know that our omega is equal to 2 pi nu. Omega equal to 2 pi nu. That is equal to 2 pi into E is equal to h nu. You know, E is equal to h nu. What is your nu? E by h. That E may be written as 2 pi into mc square divided by force. That can be written as 2 pi into m naught c square divided by h into root of 1 minus v square by c square. So you are having one equation for your omega. Likewise, now we are going to take k. Your k is equal to 2 pi by lambda, and that can be written as 2 pi by lambda is equal to h by p. H here, p in the numerator. Of course, it may be 2 pi mv by h. This can be written as 2 pi, what's that? M naught v divided by h into root of 1 minus v square by c square. So likewise, we are having concept. When you differentiate this equation with v, this equation with v, and when you substitute, your answer may be equal to v. So that group velocity which we may consider is traveling with the velocity of the particle v, and a Kadesi concept. Okay, it is, I think this is higher than your level. Of course, try to understand it, okay? Somewhat whenever you come across this type of situation, you can easily learn it, because it may be an introduction for you. Now, let us derive time-independent Schrodinger's equation. Number simple linear, please try to write this one. The total energy E is equal to kinetic energy plus potential energy. This kinetic energy may be written as half mv squared plus potential energy V. You just multiply m in the numerator and denominator. So you are getting p squared by 2m plus V. This is your V. Of course, from this, if you want, you can write your P square is equal to 2 M into E minus V. If you want, you can write it. I told wave function, no? Wave function, yeah. And the wave function, how to represent banana? You can represent in many ways. A, what's called as sine omega t plus b cos omega t, you can write it. Or you can write it in another way also. That is e power I into omega e power I into kx minus omega t. String equation principle, along the other way, that is a complex notation. Venu. Of course, you know e power I theta is equal to sin theta plus cos theta plus I sin theta. Cos theta plus I sin theta. So you just differentiate this equation twice with respect to x square. If you differentiate two times, for one time you will get I into k, two times you will get a I into k the whole square, again you will get psi. So it is nothing but minus k square into psi. You know that k is equal to 2 pi by lambda. So it can be written as 2 pi into p by h. Just to square it, h square is equal to 4 pi square p square by h square. You substitute the value of t square from here. So your answer is 4 pi square 2m within bracket e minus v whole divided by h square. So now we are going to substitute the value of k square here. D square psi by d x square equal to minus, of course you have to put minus 4 pi square, sorry 4 into 2, 8. 4 into 2, 8. 8 pi square m bracket e minus v divided by h square into psi. So now you take this one in this way, that is h square by 8 pi square m, okay, pi square m d square psi by d x square is equal to, of course if you take minus sign also here you can write minus, is equal to, you have a minus here, so you will have e psi minus d psi. We just take this v psi to this side. Ab you know your final answer may be e psi is equal to, e psi may be equal to minus h square by 8 pi square m d square psi by dx square plus v psi. This is called as time independent Schrodinger's equation. Now let us pass on to time dependent Schrodinger's equation. We know that E is equal to h nu, that can be written as h into 2 pi nu divided by 2 pi. This may be written as h into omega by 2 pi. And our wave function, like this we are writing our wave function. Differentiate once d psi by dt is equal to, what is your answer to differentiate this with minus I omega into psi you get. Is it done? So you are going to substitute minus 2, sorry, I into 2 pi into nu. Nu is nothing but E by H into psi. So keep E psi in the left side itself, E psi in the left side itself, take the other things to the right side. What you have? H minus H divided by I into 2 pi, I into 2 pi into d psi by dt. This minus is nothing but I square, is it done? So you can cancel one I here. So your answer is I into h by 2 pi into d psi by dt is equal to your E psi. When you substitute the value of E psi from the previous equation, that is time independent Schrodinger's equation, you may have E h by 2 pi d psi by dt is equal to minus h square by 8 pi square m into d square psi by d x square plus v psi. This is what we call as time dependent Schrodinger's equation. I think green is not visible to you at the end, is it? Green is not the cut is the remote. Really, yeah? Okay, no problem. Then use other colors except green. I could not see whether it is green or dark here. Yeah. I am going to discuss a concept called particle in a box. Particle in a box. One dimension only I am going to discuss. There are two dimensions, three dimensions like that we have. So let us discuss in one dimension. First you consider there is a well. Kenar Marichina. Here we have a situation like this. Inside we have a particle. That's why it is called as particle in a box. When you take V, that is potential energy inside, it is potential energy here, it is likewise we have this particle is having a mass m moving with the velocity v inside the box. It is a quantum, it is a well. So we are going to discuss, we are going to first formulate the equation of motion for this particle. In the particle called equation of motion and energy law, after solve it, that's all. So when you take here, we are going to discuss inside the box. Of course, we say that word v is equal to 0. So our time stored in just independent equation, let us take stored in just time independent equation, let us take minus h square by 8 pi square m d square psi by dx square plus v psi, V is 0, another element is equal to V psi. So now let us take d square psi by dx square only here. Your answer is minus 8 pi square m E divided by h square into psi in the right side. Okay, right. Now let us take the total energy is sum of the kinetic energy plus potential energy. Of course, this energy is going to be zero only. So the value of E is equal to only kinetic energy, half mv square. Half mv square may be written as 2 p square by m. I think we are now only we have discussed. So from this, the value of what is called as p is, or p square is equal to 2 m into e. P square is equal to 2 m into e. Now just take the value of k. wave vector, sorry, wave number 2 pi by lambda. That is nothing but 2 pi by lambda is h by p. Inga h podunga mela p podunga. Just square it. Your answer is 4 pi square p square by h square. Now substitute the value of p square. Your p square value is 2 m e divided by h square. So your k square is equal to 2 into 4, 8. 8 pi square m e by h square. So now you can write this equation d square psi by d x square is equal to minus, everything is here now, k square into psi. K square into psi. So this is the equation of the wave associated with the particle like this. இங்க இருக்கக்கூடிய அந்த வேவினுடைய ஈக்குவேஷன் தான் இது. ஈக்குவேஷன் ஆஃப் மோஷன் இன் யூ டேக் யூ கேன் ஈஸிலி ரைட் வி ஈக்குவல் டு யூ பிளஸ் ஏடி எஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு யூடி பிளஸ் ஆர் லைக் வைஸ் யூ கேன் ரைட் வி ஹவ் ரிட்டன் த ஈக்குவேஷன் ஃபார் த வேவ் அசோசியேட்டட் வித் த பார்ட்டிகல் விச் இஸ் அவைலபிள் இன் த ஒன் டைமென்ஷனல் பொட்டென்ஷியல் வெல் ஸோ வி ஆர் ஹேவிங் இட் அஃப்கோர்ஸ் யூ கேன் சால்வ் திஸ் ஈக்குவேஷன் பை ஃபார்மிங் ஆக்சிலரி ஈக்குவேஷன் Is it done? So you can also think it like this way. If you take psi is equal to A sine kx plus B cos kx. What is the value of your d squared psi by dx square? Yes, you will get a minus k square into psi. So we have assumed some value, and once if you are differentiating like this, you are getting the same equation. It means that this may be the solution for this equation. This may be the solution for that equation. இது நம்ம அசியூம் பண்ண சை ஈக்குவல் டு ஏ சைன் கேஎக்ஸ் ப்ளஸ் பி காஸ் கேஎக்ஸ் போட்டோம் இல்லையா, அது நம்மளுடைய சொல்யூஷனாக மாறிடுச்சு. அப்போ நம்மளுடைய சொல்யூஷன் இதான். அப்போ இதனுடைய சொல்யூஷனவே சைஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஏ சைன் கேஎக்ஸ் ப்ளஸ் பி காஸ் ஏ கேஎக்ஸ். வாட் ஆர் தட் ஏ அண்ட் பி? தே ஆர் ஆர்பிட்டரி கான்ஸ்டன்ட்ஸ். ஹவு கேன் யூ ஃபைண்ட் த வேல்யூ ஆஃப் ஏ அண்ட் பி? பை அப்ளையிங் பவுண்டரி கண்டிஷன்ஸ். பவுண்டரி கண்டிஷன்ஸ் நம்ம போட்டு அதை கண்டுபிடிக்கணும். Now I am going to explain it. Okay. Right. Before that, let us take the concept what is called as Bose concept. That is first postulate, Bose first postulate. Angular momentum is quantized. Is it then? Angular momentum is equal to, what's the value here? NH by 2 pi. So that angular momentum can be written as moment, this is momentum into moment. Of course, you have to take this is of length L. பொட்டன்ஷியல் டைமென்ஷனுடைய அது லென்த் எல். ஸோ இவர் எம் விஎல் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு என்ஹெச் பை 2 பை. ஃப்ரம் திஸ் கேன் யூ ஃபைண்ட் த வேல்யூ ஆஃப் எம் வி, தட் இஸ் பி இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு என்ஹெச் பை 2 பை எல். என்ஹெச் பை 2 பை எல். and you see that E is equal to, what is the value of E? Kinetic energy 2m. Substitute the value of E here, your answer is n square, okay, h square by, already you have 2m, now you are having 4 pi square l. So your answer is n square h square divided by 8 pi square m into l square, m into l square. So using this concept here, of course what we are applying here and what we have discussed so far may be controversy, but these things are in the quantum microscopic point of view. There we are discussing, say, a particle means in a potential well. It means that a single electron in a potential, say an electron in a hydrogen atom like that, we can able to consider it. So you can apply these conditions. So we are getting the energy is quantized. The quantized energy may be like this. E is equal to that value h squared by 8 pi squared m l squared, that is n equal to 1. Then when you get the second case, this is n equal to 2. Of course here we have to write 4 times the first one, n equal to 1. Likewise we have the other case, n equal to 3. Likewise the energies are like this. These are the energies available for the particle in the discrete manner like this. Whenever an electron is jumping from one state of energy to the another state of energy, you are getting some sort of energy is liberated. That may be we call as h nu. E is equal to h nu. Now let us find the value of psi by finding the value of A and B. The psi value we calculate panna ma. For that we are going to apply the boundary conditions. Take some time. See, to find A and B, just let us take a boundary condition. When x equal to 0, it means that when x equal to 0 here, what do you say about your wave function? 0. So your psi is equal to A, what's the formula? Sin kx plus B cos kx. So 0 is equal to A into sin 0, 0 plus B into cos 0, 1. So what is the value of B? B is going to be 0. So your psi is equal to A sin kx. If you are having only one arbitrary constant, say A, in order to avoid, in order to remove that one, we are going to apply something here. Of course, when you say the value of kx here, we can also apply in this way. That is, when x equal to A, again psi is equal to 0. Ingeyum psi 0 are, ingeyum psi 0 are. Appa 0 is equal to A sin k into A. Because B is 0 now. So you need not write anything here. So 0 is equal to A, cannot be equal to 0. Sin k A. Appa Ka is equal to 0, pi, 2 pi and so on. So you may call it as n pi. So your k is equal to n pi by a. Okay, here you should not write a, you write please l, because what we have so far considered here is length l. So you write as l here, n pi by l. So your final equation psi is equal to a into sine, what is that, sine into n pi by l into x, into x. Now I have to find the value of a. For that we have a concept called normalization condition. Can I erase all the things here? Normalization condition. That is, in the interval 0 to L, if you take the probability density function equal to 1. So you are having it like this. So now you are going to substitute the value of 0 to L, and this is nothing but a, what is that, a psi square into dx. So you can write this value is equal to 0 to L into a square sine square n pi by L into dx is equal to 1. So now you are going to solve this equation. So you just take a square out, 0 to L sine square n pi by L into dx. Okay. Is equal to 1. Of course, you know that cos 2 theta is equal to cos square theta minus sin square theta, or cos 2 theta is equal to 1 minus 2 sin square theta. So using this concept, you can write this equation and solve it. Once if you are solving it, your answer is a square into L by 2 da varo. You just look into it. I can solve it now, but it's near the mathematical steps only. So the value of A is found to be root of 2 by L. So your final equation of psi is equal to root of 2 by L into sine, what is that, n pi by L into x. So this is the, what is called as a wave function associated with the particle inside the box. Particle irukkudiya box ke irukkudiya wave function idu energy modele calculate pannom idha vandha adanudaiya wave function. Copy. let us introduce something called harmonic operators. Operators. We have thing called h square by 8 pi square m into d square psi by dx square plus v of psi is equal to e psi. You can write this equation as h psi is equal to e psi. This h cat, the spelling for this pronunciation is cat. H cat. This H cat we call it as Hamiltonian operator. Likewise, we have P is equal to what is called as K H by 2 pi. We appreciate K equal to 2 pi by lambda. 2 pi by lambda is nothing but H by P. Okay, H by P, that is your K value. Okay, so using this concept here, when you take the value of P, P may be equal to K into H by 2 pi. So here we can write P, P cat, that is operator, momentum operator is equal to K into H by 2 pi, this is momentum operator. Likewise, we have operators here. I think what I have taken so far here now, it is more than your level. Okay. If you have any doubt in these things here, please come to my room, that is at room number, main building, 245. Or you can, I think on the day itself I have given my email, no? TV, that TV, Bridge, 2014 at gmail.com. Thank you very much. Very small announcement.